What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you a free motion graphics intro template, and I'll also show you how to create it in Adobe Premiere Pro. In this video, you'll learn how to create a custom motion graphics intro, how to turn that into a template, and how to customize the intro in Adobe Premiere Pro. Alright guys, so let's go ahead and dive in. So right now on my screen, I have a sequence open. It's a 1080p sequence. It's just standard at 60 frames per second too, because that's best for motion graphics. Let's go ahead and start creating this intro. So first thing I'm going to do is drag in some footage, keep existing settings, just so we have something to drag it on top of. Next, let's go inside of Essential Graphics. And if you don't have this window open, just go to Window, go all the way down to Essential Graphics and click on that. And then you'll notice that we're in Browse. So let's just go ahead and click on Edit. And to create a new graphic, let's just hit this new layer and then click on rectangle, okay? So now we've got this gray rectangle, and what I wanna do is I wanna turn off the fill, turn on the stroke, and make the stroke black, okay? And we can't really see it, so let's just extend this out. I'm gonna make it about like 5 points, okay? And then see how it says shape one up top? Let's go ahead and rename this. Let's call this small outline. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and right click and duplicate it. Now let's call this top one big outline. So we got a small and big outline, and what we're gonna do with the big outline is we're just gonna bring the scale right here on the left side of the screen, and we're just gonna scale this up. And you'll see the rectangle, it's just a little bit bigger, okay? And you'll see the stroke is showing up a little bit more too. I'm actually gonna size these up just a little more. Okay, so now that we've got our boxes with the outlines, let's go ahead and put our logo inside too. So let's go to From File from that new layer button. I'm gonna import this Replace Me logo, and I'm going to size this all the way down so it fits right inside of the box, okay? Let me go ahead and drag this graphic to the beginning of our clip. Let's just put our playhead there. And let's start adding some animation to it. So let's take the small outline, and instead of being inside of Essential Graphics, we'll have to animate it inside of Effect Controls. It gives us more freedom and the ability to add keyframes. So in Effect Controls, you can see there's the shape, the small outline, and what I wanna do is I just want to mess around with the opacity. So I'm gonna hit the toggle animation. My playhead's at the beginning. So I have toggle animation, opacity is at 100. So I'm gonna bring it down to 0. Let's do shift to the right, bring it up to 100, or 99, bring it to 100. Shift to the right, bring it down to 0, shift to the right, bring it up to 100. So if we see it, you can see it kind of flickers on. So I'm gonna select all these keyframes, I'm gonna right click them and put them on hold. So that means every time a keyframe passes, it's gonna go directly to that value instead of animating to it. So you can see it's more of a flicker. Okay, so now let's go to the last keyframe of the small outline and let's line it up with the beginning keyframe on the big outline. So let's hit opacity, bring it down to 0, hold shift, press the right key, bring it up to 100, shift, press the right key, down to 0, shift, press the right key, up to 100. Select them all, right click, put them to hold. So now they both flash on, see that? They just flash on together. All right, so now I'm gonna animate the logo real quick too. I don't want it to flash, but I do want it to kind of come in through opacity and zooming and maybe a little bit of rotation. So let's start at the opacity and let's hold shift and bring our playhead to the final keyframe of the big outline, okay? Because that's when I want it to become 100. So I'm gonna go back to the first keyframe here, set it to 0, and then let's do the scale as well. So I'm gonna bring the scale, match this keyframe up to the other one, because that's where we want it to be, but let's start it small. So let's start at like 10. Okay, so when we play it, the logo zooms in, right? So let me also do a little rotation. Put that at 0, go to the next keyframe, put that at 0. And the first keyframe for rotation should be maybe like a negative like 8. Let's see how that looks. All right, that looks pretty cool. It's a cool little zoom in here with some flickering. Now I'm gonna start creating the transition for the intro to where the logo comes in, but then it kind of goes to black and then reveals the next scene, okay? So let's hop back into the Essential Graphics panel and let's duplicate the small outline. Let's just duplicate it. And then we're gonna call this small box instead. So it's the same size as the small outline. And now what we can do is turn off the stroke, but turn on the fill, and let's make this black. Okay, so when we scroll in here, we'll notice that the box is here now, okay? And it's taking up that middle area. And we're also gonna do the same for the big outline. duplicate it, make the fill black, turn off that stroke. Okay, and then we're also going to duplicate this big box, and we're going to call this the huge box. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this and I'm just going to expand it all the way out to be full frame. Okay, so this is kind of like the three steps toward transition, right? So let's go back to the effect controls panel and we'll minimize everything. And now we're just going to focus on the small box. So let me turn off the big and the huge box. So we got the small box. And what I want to do to make it appear, I don't want it to show up yet, but I want it to kind of like start the transition. So I'll go about here. Let's turn off uniform scale. And then let's keep that horizontal scale at 125. But let's start animating the vertical scale, okay? So I'm just gonna drag this out, put another keyframe, and let's put the vertical scale to 0. All right, so now when we play it, boom, we got that vertical scale. I'm gonna make it a little faster too. Okay, so now that that scales up, I also want the big box to scale up too. So let's turn on the big box, bring the parameters down, turn off that uniform scale, and I actually want the horizontal scale to animate this time. So I'm going to put a keyframe here. Let's go a little bit over, and then let's put another keyframe and let's max that out. What was it, 125 or no, 150, right? And then go back to the first keyframe, and then bring it down to 0. So now when we play it, that expands out too, okay? Now both of these are above the logo. Let me just put the logo on top. There we go. So now we can see when we play it, the transition starts. All right, kind of starts. And then at the end of this one, at the end of the big box, let's do the huge box now, okay? So let's do the same thing. So scale, I want this to start here. I'm going to turn off uniform scale, bring the vertical scale down. I think horizontal is supposed to be 150. And then let's go over here. Let's bring this up to, 150? Yeah. Okay, so let's go check it out real quick. So start at the beginning. Bam, look at that. So that's pretty cool, right? So now when it fills up the screen, let's go to that last keyframe, hold shift, just snap to the keyframe. When it fills up that frame, I want to start creating like a gap so that it opens up to the next scene. Okay, so let's go ahead and minimize transform and appearance, and let's just mess with the mask. So I'm going to hit this 4-point polygon mask. And what we did is we made it so that it only shows what's inside the mask, but let's invert it so it cuts a hole inside. Okay, so we're gonna cut this hole inside and you'll notice it reveals the your logo here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna zoom out. Let's go to like 50, or no, let's go to 25%. And let's turn on this safe margins button. You can get that from the plus button here. You can just kind of drag it into your toolbar. Safe margins, okay? I'm gonna drag all these keyframes or these points, and I'm gonna kind of like line them up with that very middle horizontal line. You see that? I'm just gonna kinda, okay. Let's bring that feather down. Okay, so it's all lined up now and we have the mask expansion at 0. So let's make that maybe like a little negative, because if we have it at 0, you can see there's a gap here. But if we make it negative, it's gone. So let's put this keyframe here and then let's go over a little bit and then let's expand it all the way, open up, bam. Now we can see everything, okay? So now let's play it. Your logo here, fill. Okay, but we don't want to see the logo anymore after the transition. So once this opens, like, I don't want to see that logo. So let's go here and let's make sure that at this point, everything goes to 0 opacity. So what I want to do is go into the clip. Let's go to opacity. I'll hit this keyframe for 100, go to the next one, bring it down to 0. I'm going to do minimize that, do the same for all the shapes. All right, so now that all of my opacities are set, you can see by these dots here, these circular dots, this is where the opacity is kind of turned off. And that's right when the mask starts expanding on the huge box. See that? So it really starts expanding. So now let's go ahead and play this clip, see what everything looks like. Bada bing, look at that transition. I love it. All right, so now when it turns fully black, I'm going to cut it to another part of the scene. All right, so let's kind of trim this clip. And you'll see, we start with the flowers, we got our logo, and then let's, there we go, and now we transitioned. You heard my little snip, I'm gonna turn off the audio there. So yeah, so I'm also going to ease in all of these animations, so the mask expansion, all the first keyframes should be an ease out, all the second keyframes should be ease in. Perfect. All right, now let's see how smooth this is after doing all that easing. Smooth, smooth, smooth. Look at that, gorgeous. All right guys, so as always, you can download this template that we just created right in the description. It's the first link there. It'll take you to a page where you just type in your email and go from there. You can also see a link down there that points you towards the YouTube Motion Graphics Academy that's currently on a wait list. You can sign up for early bird presale access. Just click that link too. And also you'll notice that you can do one-on-one tutoring with me. So that's also in the description. But yeah, for now, I will leave you guys with this video. And it is a simple logo animation tutorial messing around with 7-Eleven. So please check that out. I know you'll like it, and I will see you there.